back for our final Thursday segment on season 20. Looking forward to getting back to our art and good puns. So we're heading over to AOTL, where we have plenty of both. Is that, how's that sum you guys up over there?
That's something for worth doing here at AOTL Studios.
So what are you drawing today?
I'm drawing a cityscape and then just going on from there.
Any particular city give you some sort of just inspiration, or just you just like this the look of a city at night?
See, Bianca was wanted me to do a uphill cityscape, like diagonal, in this picture form, which looks like this.
Oh, okay. Wow.
Get inspiration from the computer.
No, Crawford.
Oh, Crawford's painting, right.
Crawford did a painting?
Yeah, so the painting looks a lot like this.
Okay.
And so it's time for me to get creative. Bianca, when I get done with this, Bianca's going to cut it all out when I do it. And then she's going to mod podge it onto the canvas picture thing like this.
All right, a collaborative piece. I love it. So we are getting to see all of the amazing processes that AOTL has to make some of their really innovative pieces. So I'll let you get to it.
Okay, so first, there is a way to draw a building. So this building is going to start on the lowest part of the paper and make a line. The lines won't even have to be as straight as you think they would be, but we have a little bit of a almost rectangle here. So it's like if you're doing a cup without a bottom. I see Dusty is putting his head down like, oh, I gotta rub my face against the paper here. Shut up, George Riffle. Now, we do some more lines. Okay. Another line up this way. And so far, it's going to look like this shape right here. Thumbs up if you can see. That looks a lot like that. There's a technique I'm going to show you later when I get the buildings all put together. There's another building and another line over here. And see. And so far, it's going to look like this. Looks like it's all bar graph, but it's not really bar graphical. As far as you can tell. So you got that. If you're following along, you're rolling down memory lane with this thing. Then, as you can tell, the mountainous buildings are just going to keep on going up and up and up. So it's going to, first I'm going to take these lines and go down. And then take the low mountains, or buildings. They're not mountains, they're just buildings. And they look like this so far. It almost looks like you're climbing a square mountain. There you have all that. Then we're gonna take this other line and go up. And that's the last outside mountain. Then I'm going to take it to the top, connecting from that mountain. I keep saying mountain. What's up with me? Climb every mountain. It's usually a song my mom sings. Now I have to get that on my head. You know where that's from. So that looks like that so far. See, you got that thumbs up if you can see. You see that, okay? Yeah. I assume that you got all that. And now we go to the outside mountain, inside mountains, where are buildings, not mountains, buildings. Get this mountain out of my head. I am not climbing every mountain, people. So if you ever think of my mom, think of that song, but get it out your head, because she really is a good singer. So anyway, back on topic. So that building looks like that. Cool, I see a thumbs up from somebody. I wonder if that's one of the things. I want to check here. Okay. So then we do another building that looks a lot like it's a gigantic building. So it would look like this. We got ADS on here. I wonder what that term even says. Okay, so we got one more building, not mountain, building to even put up in there. That's as far as I could go with the buildings. So we keep on building this wonderful mountainous building set. I try to refrain and restrain myself from saying mountain, because whether if you're mounting a Yoshi, well, that buildings look a lot like that. What are you trying to do? With your hand. Want me to mute you? Or unmute you? Okay. You're unmuted, whoever you are. What do you got to say about this wonderful piece so far?
Pretty good.
Thank you.
Yep.
I thought you were hearing me say mountains more than I have said buildings. But no, I kept saying buildings instead, so that's good. I'm gonna mute you now.
Yeah.
And then.
Okay, thank you. Keep the door open, please.
And then we are now going to do some line work. Here's a strategy that I think of it with your pencil. When I do this, the lines, I'll show you when I get to it here. The lines are simple. They go, you can do it any way you want, but my trick is, the harder you press on the paper, the more clear it becomes. Like on that line on the top. Cool. So, this I go down the way like that, all the way down the building, the skyscraper, the tall 90-foot building, the statue of Builder Team, Builder with Liberty. Okay, thank you, Mara. So the building would look a lot like this so far. See how epic that building is. It's one cool building right there. And then we do more line work. This time we're gonna go up from the bottom to the top. And this is on the outside building. The building facing inside or something. And the building looks like this. You can tell the lines from my sign are looking very sharp. A lot detailed. Then there's another building, but this time the windows are going to be filled in with this. I'll go with every other inch or two down to make it scale better. It's going to look like this one, fill it in and then show it off to the crowd. Okay. We're gonna have some pun and fun with this building technique because it builds character in everything I do with y'all on PALS TV at Art Outside the Lines. So therefore, the building's gonna look like this. That nice shade in pool. Okay, thank you. Then we need to do some other buildings and some dots. Like if you're filling in circles and something. Just make circleized dots. And art takes patience when you do windows individually like this. I'll try to be fast, but not too fast, or I'll screw up. That's the magic of art. Because when I do it, it's just the best thing. I eat, sleep, drink, feel, bleed, breathe art. It's every man's dream come true. So this is going to be a perfect piece to put onto Crawford's already existing piece to call that a blending collaboration. And that kind of stuff. So we're just gonna keep putting lines, and dots until we get the whole paper and it's gonna look professional. Just so that we get big benefit and money for it in they'll be split evenly, or at least get their own prices for that nice collaboration piece. Like I do for many people, because I love to collaborate. Here's a little pun jokes for you guys. Like, I told Mara in the background that this one joke about REO Speedwagon, there is this Italian band that when they joined REO Speedwagon, it becomes Mario Speedwagon. Although I've never even heard of using a Ouija board, but if you consider Mario's brother Luigi one, it's called a Luigi board. You never even know a royal peach than Princess Peach. And does Princess Peach ever wonder what Toad's worth? Because there's a character named Toadsworth. And it's a pun, a two-way pun. It's based on how much Toad is worth and Toad's worth, as in the character that proves to be Peach's steward or something. So it's like, takes care of Peach, like Magic Koopa takes care of Bowser and his son. Therefore, that's a little bit of Mario puns for you there. And when it gets hot in the Mushroom Kingdom, how hot does it get? Warp piping hot. And what pants does Mario like to wear? Denim, denim, denim. As in denim, 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 denim. Doesn't roll off the tongue easily. And how does well, here's a joke. Let me think first before I really go for it. Until I think of some more jokes, I'm going to say that this half of the building's almost done. And go. There's that one building that looks like that. And I'm very talented at buildings like these. The skyscrapers are cool to me and everyone else. Now we're going to do some half lines up this way. I'm thinking some more mushrooms. I mean, jokes. Yes. trying to think of some more jokes. Maybe I'll find some Hyrule or Legend of Zelda jokes since my brain is somewhat out of Mario jokes for now. So, when do you find out that when does Zelda know when he's visited that one website before? When Link is purple. Link is purple. When Link turns purple, that is even more so. Good, Bianco. Telling some punny jokes on video games to people. This is how the other building looks so far.
Ooh.
Wow. I'm gonna do some mini little lines this way, so it's like 2 or 3 inches up. Some are just gonna be a little imperfect, but that's okay. That's the beauty of our time here at PALS TV / Art Outside the Lines.
Perfectly unperfect?
Yep. And speaking of puns, how does a cat like his art when it's perfect?
So I drew this.
Make the lines even. That looks that so far. Getting a little drippy, huh? I see some positivity in the hand movements over there on aisle 5. Oh wait, it's aisle 3. There's some more lines up this way. Some are just gonna be not to the top, but its highest limit is there. I'm trying to think of a good joke based on Magic Koopas and Kamek.
Draw the breast
first, so I get an idea of where they are. I don't know exactly where the breasts are. I may draw in breast. Here's one. Here's a joke. Yeah. What is Magic Koopa's favorite sanitizer based on? Chemicals. Because Chemic's his name.
Oh, ha,
ha, ha. The lines like this so far. Then there's some big windows, but they're not going to be filled in because they're just wind squares, because they're not shaped like circles, as in windows, they're wind squares.
Can you use Windex?
Windex.
That was a stupid joke. That was more of a...
To be windexterous when you're doing it in a masculine, strong way.
What do you think, Bianca?
But you have to have a mask to be masculine. Not usually, but that's what a shy guy wears if he wants to be masculine. He's already masculine because of the guy in his name. And he sounds like one, too. The way they sound is pretty funny, too, so... That's also a gimme. Some lines, squares, rectangles. And here's another Kamek joke. What shapes do Magi Koopa throw at Mario? PlayStation controller buttons. Because they're square, circle, and triangle, the primary shapes. So there's this meme here that a motivational art thing that has Kamek throwing his shapes at Mario from Yoshi's Island, and it says, "Kamek, stop throwing those PlayStation controller symbols at me." That's literally what they are. Keep making more. Rectangles, rectangles. Oh, here's another great. Here's a really great one. What is Wreck-It Ralph's favorite dance move? Rectangos. There's the many triangles, or not triangles, squares on that building, as you can see. Cool. I needed to be unmuted so far. Okay, you're unmuted.
Okay, look at my drawings.
Oh, cool.
Yep, I even drew a city of Columbus, Ohio.
Sweet, I like that city.
I like your creative art activity, George.
Thank you.
Yeah.
You like my puns so far?
Yeah.
Cool. And I'm going to mute you up again. Then. You keep. Let's get back to the basic lines across the building.
And do a color on the
baby. La da 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 da. You're doing good on time. We still have time for the dance thing. I had to kind of speed it up. It's only like 1:32, so.
No, that's not purple.
So far, we got this. Nice lines on this thing.
No,
as you can see.
No.
There it is. Now, we do more dots across the way.
I need suitable purple shape.
These dots are gonna be really cool.
Okay. So, you want me to make the bathing suit a mixture of these three purples?
More dots. Dip dots.
Hey,
everybody.
Hey.
Hey, Phil.
We're on PALS TV.
Mm-hmm. Got a big, nice looking city up in here.
Yeah.
Yeah,
looking weird in a whole different way. Not so weird.
My hand's going tired. That's a sign that I've been doing excellent with this drawing. I'm going to give up a level and a turn. Make some more dip dots. So far, we have this detail here on this penultimate building.
We're going to lock up all this stuff.
Oh, that is so good. And last but totally not the least of all this stuff, we have this last set of lines to go up this one building here. That looks great.
I did really well in school.
You did?
Yep. There's one point where I got all A's in my class.
Which school did you go
to? For elementary school, I went to Wigley. For middle school, I went to Jones. And for high school, I went to Upper Arlington.
And these lines
schooling, you learn what you need to learn.
There's that final building up here, and those are all the buildings. So that is. Thank you, Jimmy. So that's all the buildings I have to do today.
Nice. You're done?
Yep. Yeah. That's ready to be cut out, and it should fit onto this canvas thing.
I hope so.
Yeah.
Okay. Hey, everyone.
Hey, y'all. All
right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut these out. Let's see what they look like on here.
Yeah.
Hey, bro. Can you set up the karaoke machine and sign us out with a beautiful song? Yes, ma'am. Come on, give us a song.
Yes, ma'am.
What do you think I said? He said yes, ma'am.
What am I singing?
Who's singing with him? George, you
want to
sing with him?
I'll sing with him.
Nice. Okay, what do you guys want to sing?
Any song. Like, I can make up the lyrics. We got one to... Unmute here. You're unmuted.
Which one?
You're unmuted. Oops. What's happening over here? Okay.
What you Dusty. Guys?
Dusty.
What?
You're unmuted.
Yes, I am. I want to hear Living on a Prayer and Dude Looks Like a Lady by Aerosmith.
All right. Living on a Prayer or Dude Looks Like a Lady?
Living on a Prayer.
Living on a Prayer. That one?
All right. Cool.
Our maestro's got it. Okay, Georgie. You can go over there and I'll bring the laptop for you guys.
Okay. See you over there.
See you when
you guys like to do karaoke?
Yep.
Yeah, Nick does. Awesome. Yeah, we have a karaoke machine over here, so it gets pretty crazy over here.
Sounds right.
All right, I'm almost done, y'all. All right, Jimmy. So I think I'm going to cut it out a little more, but this is basically what it's going to look like. Whoa.
What up, y'all?
All right.
Here in the studio.
We're here live at AOTL. We're going to bring down the house with these crazy artists. All right, you guys, here's the camera. Make sure you get pretty for the camera.
Hold on, I got to...
Crazy. What people are crazy. Long
enough. It
should work.
Is it on the stool? Can we grab the stool real
quick? Oh, yeah. Here. I'm just making up there.
Union's been on strike, he's down on his luck. so tough. Gina was a diner all day, working for her man. She brings him her day for the love. Oh, love. She said, we've got a hold on to what we've got. It doesn't make a difference if we make it or not. We've got each other, and that's a lot for us.
Make someone the host, Jonah?
You're the host.
Oh, I know, but did you need me to kick it back to you or something?
No.
Oh, okay.
That was awesome. Thank you for playing Bon Jovi, brightening my day, and just, so the only thing, I would like to hear you guys hit that key change a little bit better. So in the bridge, right there, he does that key change. But other than that, that was spectacular. Bravo,
big guru.
So that totally makes up for the last time that you guys ended us with music, because the last time that AOTL wrapped up our show, music, they brought it home with the Spice Girls. So I feel like that totally made up for it. You guys nailed it.
What's wrong with the Spice Girls?
Nothing. I did tell everybody that a successful TV segment ending with the Spice Girls hasn't happened since the 1990s. So I was impressed.
Ending with Bon Jovi is
lots of good things. And with Bon Jovi, he is a saint. All right. A saint. So